What's up, guys? So, today we got the trailer for the first DLC pack in COD World War II. And obviously, every year, DLC 1 is a big deal. Most people are still really enjoying the game, and it's about that time where it's like, hey, we kind of want something new. So, we're only a couple of weeks away. It's going to be coming out on January 30th, and we've got a little bit of gameplay from some of the new maps here from the trailer today. Now, if you guys don't know, World War II is going to be a little bit different in terms of DLC offerings. So, in the past, we've had 4 new multiplayer maps and then 1 new zombies map. This year, we're getting 3 new multiplayer maps, 1 new war map, and then 1 new zombies map. So, in total, there are 5 pieces of new content, and technically, there's a little bit more content than we've had in the past because, you know, a war map in exchange for a regular multiplayer map. War maps are definitely like way bigger. So there is more content there, but at the same time, we also have 1 less MP map, which I don't know, like I feel like that's the one thing that this game is lacking is enough maps. I feel like I play on the same maps over and over. So I feel like it is gonna hurt a little bit not to have that 4th multiplayer map in the game, but I enjoy war. I don't really play it that much because I play solo a lot and war is awful to play solo. So anyway, let's talk about what we're going to be getting in this pack. So for the multiplayer maps, the first one we're going to be getting is Valkyrie, and this one is based in Prussia at Hitler's Wolf's Lair. So this is like a giant compound out in the middle of the forest in what's now Poland, and it's where like Hitler and all of his high-ranking officers had this like big secret lair that was super hard to get to, and there were all these missions to try to get in there and take these guys out. I think this map is actually going to be pretty cool, and in the trailer they said that along the outsides you're going to have long lines of sight for, you know, sniper and AR engagements or rifle engagements. There are no ARs in this game, but then in the interior you're going to have a lot of tight close quarters, like bunker to bunker type action. So that's where the subs and the shotguns are going to come into play. So it's going to be one of those maps where, depending on where you want to, like what you want to use, you can play in different areas of the map. So that's nice. It's going to have a little bit of diversity there, and it sounds like it's going to be pretty cool fighting out in the middle of the forest in this like hidden secret lair. So that's going to be awesome. Now the next map we have is called Anthropoid, and this one is in occupied Prague. So this is going to be an urban map. They said that it's going to be for the most part pretty close quarters, but they also added a bit of verticality to it. So we're going to have second and then maybe third story windows, and it looked like there might be like kind of an underground area and stuff like that. But it's going to be another urban map, so think something like Aachen, where it's, you know, for the most part those close to medium range engagements. So that sounds kind of cool. And then finally, last but not least, what I consider a really good thing, but then also kind of a bad thing, we're going to be getting Occupation, and this is going to be a remake of Resistance. So Resistance was one of my favorite maps from back in the day. I am very, very, very happy that they're bringing this back, because this was seriously, it was an amazing map. It was a great size, you had great engagements, there were good flank routes, like, it was a very well-built map. But the problem is we're getting a remade map. So for everybody who played Resistance back in the day, technically with this DLC pack, we're getting 2 new maps added to the game for multiplayer. And that, oh, it hurts me a little bit. Like, I always love remade maps, and I know I'm gonna love playing on this thing, but I just, like, I also kind of want new stuff. Like, I wish we could get remade maps as a part of, like, season passes and then get all new stuff in these DLCs. I don't know. I don't know, dude. I wish we could have entirely new stuff as well, but I'm still excited for Resistance 2. I'm hoping that it doesn't, like, I'm hoping we have enough maps after this DLC pack to make it not seem like we're playing the same map over and over, like it kind of feels like right now. So those are the new multiplayer maps coming into the game. Now, talking about the war map, it's called Operation Intercept. It focuses on the heart of the FFI, which is the French Forces of the Interior. And we've got a couple of new objectives and stuff. So we're going to be rushing in and trying to rescue these resistance fighters, these French fighters. They're being held captive. So you got to like defeat the enemies and then unhandcuff them and stuff like that. We're going to have to capture radio equipment. We're going to have to lead the attack back against the Axis. It's gonna be pretty cool. I'm looking forward to it. War mode, like I said, is fun. I really enjoy it. I think it's one of the best new additions to Call of Duty, but it's just, it's very frustrating to play in pubs when you're on like Operation Neptune and your entire team is sniping in the water and you're the only one pushing. So I don't know, we'll see what they do. They might be able to funnel people more into playing the objective with this one. We'll see what happens, but that's the new war map. And then finally, last but not least, we've got zombies. So this actually looks pretty sick. It's called The Darkest Shore, and they said that this is the darkest, scariest one that we've had yet. So I mean, the default map we have for zombies is already pretty like legitimate. Like, that's definitely the scariest one we've had yet. So if this one is even scarier, then that's a good thing. And they say that the storyline is that Dr. Straub has moved to this like remote island. So the characters are following him to this island, and this island has a fog problem. So we've got kind of like this dynamic interactive weather where every once in a while, this fog is gonna roll in and you have to play on this island with this really intense fog where you can't really see in front of you. You can only see like a few feet in front of you. So these zombies, as soon as you see them, they're like right on top of you. So that sounds pretty intense. Not to mention they said that they do have a new zombie. He's the scariest zombie that we've seen yet. And he's smart. He like looks at what you're doing and reacts to it. And he's very like strategic and stuff like that. So that sounds pretty intense. We've got a smart learning AI zombie on our hands. So that's gonna be pretty cool. And then they also said they had a new weapon called the Ripsaw. So it's like a variation of a buzzsaw, but in a gun. So think about the fog, like you just see these ominous figures popping out right in front of you. You got a buzzsaw and you're just sawing people down. I think that could be pretty cool. So there you guys have it. That's the new DLC in this game. Like I said, we've got three new multiplayer maps. One of them is a remake of a previous map. So we have two new multiplayer maps. We've got a war map, and then we've got a zombies map. Now, I'm excited for Resistance. I'm hoping, like, I think the addition of three good multiplayer maps into this game would do wonders. I think it would be great to kind of have this fresh, like, infusion into multiplayer, and I'm hoping that they're all pretty good. So we'll see what happens. Let me know what you guys think down in the comments. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'm gonna catch you guys later. Peace out.